गुड आफ्टरनून वन एंड ऑल. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू परफॉर्म एक्सपेरिमेंट नंबर 4 ऑफ फार्मास्यूटिकल केमिस्ट्री 1. इन दैट द एम ऑफ द एक्सपेरिमेंट इज टू परफॉर्म एंड रिपोर्ट द लिमिट टेस्ट फॉर सल्फेट ऑन द गिवन सैम्पल एज पर IP. इन दैट यू हैव टू डिटरमाइन द लिमिट टेस्ट इन प्यूरिफाइड वाटर देन फॉर सोडियम बाइकार्बोनेट एंड फॉर सोडियम कैल्शियम ग्लूकोनेट सोल्यूशन. इन प्रीवियस एक्सपेरिमेंट दैट इज एक्सपेरिमेंट नंबर 3 यू स्टडीड दैट इज वॉट इज लिमिट टेस्ट एंड द वॉट इज द प्रिंसिपल बिहाइंड टू डिटरमाइन द लिमिट टेस्ट फॉर क्लोराइड. नाउ सी द दिस इज द लिमिट टेस्ट फॉर सल्फेट. फॉर दिस एक्सपेरिमेंट वी रिक्वायर द सेम रिक्वायरमेंट्स दैट इज अ पेयर ऑफ नेसलर सिलेंडर देन वुडन स्टैंड ग्लास रॉड पिपेट्स and measuring cylinders we require. Here we require the chemicals like sodium bicarbonate, calcium gluconate, purified water, alcohol, barium sulfate, ethanolic sulfated standard solution of 10 ppm and 5 molar acetic acid and barium chloride and 2 molar hydrochloric acid. So we require these chemicals. The principle behind this limit test is that here there is a barium chloride reacts with sulfate ion in presence of ethanolic sulfate solution and it helps to form a precipitate of barium sulfate. See, the reaction is given here. It forms a precipitate of barium sulfate. In this experiment, we use ethanol which prevents supersaturation. Now see the procedure. In that, we have to prepare standard solution and 3 test solution. So in standard solution, when we prepare standard solution and different test solution, the procedure is like, for we have to add in that all solution, we have to add first 25% weight by volume barium chloride, then ethanolic sulfated standard solution, then 5 molar acetic acid, then we find an opalescence. We have to compare the opalescence of test all test solution with our standard solution. Now see how to prepare standard solution and different test solution. Then we have to compare the opalescence and find out our sulfate is available in the limit or out of the limit. Let's see how to prepare standard solution. For that, we have to take Nestle cylinder. In that, we have to take 1 ml of 25% weight by volume solution of barium chloride. We take 1 ml solution of barium chloride. Then in second step, we have to add 1.5 ml of ethanolic sulfate standard solution, which is 10 ppm SO4 is contained in that mix, allowed to stand for 1 minute. Then we have to add 0.15 ml of 5 molar acetic acid in that Nestle cylinder. Then in next step, we have to add sufficient water to produce 50 ml, stir immediately and with the help of glass rod and allow to stand for 5 minutes. So our standard solution get ready. Now see how to prepare the second test solution of purified water. For that we take 10 ml of purified water in labeled Nestle cylinder. Then after that we have to add 0.1 ml of 2 molar hydrochloric acid. See the next step. So by using graduated pipette, we added 0.1 ml 2 molar hydrochloric acid. Then in next step, we have to add here 0.1 ml of 25% barium chloride solution. Then make up volume up to 50 ml. Now see the T2 solution, that is test solution of sodium bicarbonate, we have to prepare. For this, we require 1 ml of 25% weight by volume solution of barium chloride in labeled Nestle cylinder. We have to take. Then we have to add 1.5 ml ethanolic sulfate standard solution in that. In next step, we have to add 1 gram of sodium bicarbonate and add to a labeled Nestle cylinder. Then in next step, we have to add 10 ml of distilled water and neutralize with hydrochloric acid and dilute to 15 ml with distilled water. So we make the solution neutralize by using hydrochloric acid, so there is a no change in litmus paper. So there, see the next step, we have to add 15 ml water. Then we have to add in next step, that is 0.15 ml of 5 molar acetic acid. After that we have to add sufficient water to produce 50 ml. Stir immediately with glass rod and allow to stand for 5 minutes. So we make up the volume up to 50 ml and stand it. We have to prepare T3, that is a test solution for calcium gluconate. In that we have to take 1 ml 25% weight by volume solution of barium chloride in the labeled Nestle cylinder. Then we have to add 1.5 ml of ethanolic sulfate standard solution. After adding the ethanolic sulfate standard solution, we have to add 1 gram calcium gluconate. Standard solution and test one, that is purified test solution of purified water. So you observe that after 1 hour there is a no change in appearance of test solution of purified water after 1 hour. See, so the given sample of purified water complies the limit test for sulfate as per IP. Comparison between standard and test solution of sodium bicarbonate. So we observe that here opalescence produced in test solution of sodium bicarbonate is more as compared to standard, so it does not comply the test and it does not passes the limit test for sulfate as per IP. See, then when we compare the test solution of calcium gluconate with standard, the opalescence produced by calcium gluconate is more than that of the standard solution, so the given sample of calcium gluconate does not or not complies the limit test for sulfate as per IP.